You're listening to the Debbie Daly Show. Now broadcasting live on Spreaker.com. Debbie Daly, changing the world. One caller at a time.
Well, she's all you'd ever want. She's the kind I'd like to flaunt and take to dinner. But she always knows her place. She's got style, she's got grace. She's a winner. She's a lady. Oh, 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 she's a lady. Talking about that little lady. And the lady is mine. But she's never in the way. Always something nice to say. What a blessing. I can leave her on her own. Knowing she's okay alone. And there's no messing. She's a
Dragon from the 420 Grindhouse, and you're listening to the Debbie Daly Show.
The Debbie Daly Show.
They're so angry at their own sense of lack of accomplishment, and the only thing they can do is blame someone else for it.
The Debbie Daly Show.
The Debbie Daly Show. The Debbie Daly
Show. That's great.
And when they're worried about you, you've got them where you want them.
The Debbie Daly
Debbie
Show.
Debbie, Debbie Daly, Daly Show. Daly
Show.
Daly
Show.
All right, I'm here on a, what is it, Thursday night? God, it feels like, I don't know, I'm completely messed up on this week. I don't know what it is. But how many of y'all remember the other night when I was talking about how bad it would be to, or how bad it is to go with the idea that everyone gets a trophy? And how I think, well, I love you too, Sissy. My daughter just said I love you. I am outraged. Here in Dallas, we have all these different little cities, right? We have Plano, Richardson, Garland, South Lake, thousands of them, it seems. Plano is one of the ones that's, well, it's sort of the, where people live that have a little bit, they have, it's like the, excuse me, upper middle class, okay? Well, there's a high school there that's called Plano Senior High School, and it's where, you know, the richer kids go, I guess you could say, right? Well, I have some news about Plano Senior High School, and I know why it happened. The headline reads, Plano Senior High School students will not be allowed to display honors during graduation, all right? And it reads, if you were a member of the National Honor Society, you definitely remember wearing the white satin stole with the National Honor Society seal during high school graduation, signifying your membership. And if you didn't get to wear one, you probably remember being envious of those who did. Because it might make other students feel excluded, students will not be able to wear National Honor Society stoles during graduation ceremonies next month at Plano Senior High School. Students are not allowed to wear NHS, which is National Honor Society, regalia, or any club or organization regalia during graduation ceremonies, according to the new school practices. Apparently, students at Plano East High School and Plano West High School will be able to wear them. In order to be a member of the National Honor Society, a student must maintain a high GPA and perform many community service hours. I am appalled. And you know why? Because it goes back to everybody got a trophy. Because it says right here that students will not be able to wear them because other students will feel bad and sad. Well, big effing deal. You didn't study as hard. You didn't come from better genetics. Get over it. There's some audio. Let's hear what this is. Maybe, if it opens. We'll see. It might take a while. Well, anyway, we'll... Here we go.
Many schools are going through graduation right now with parents rightly proud of their children's accomplishments. But some plain old parents say their kids are not getting what they have earned. Channel 8's Bradley Blackburn tonight live with that story for us. Bradley?
John, you know what we're talking about here. It's those white collars that National Honor Society members wear when they cross the stage at graduation. You've probably seen it, and it's a mark of students that have a high GPA and are committed to community service. But here at Plano Senior High, members cannot wear them, and at least one student wants that policy to change.
In 9 days, Garrett Frederick will be a high school graduate.
After I graduate, I'm going to be attending the University of South Carolina.
He can't wait to walk across the stage, but he's frustrated something will be missing.
But it's like white, it has the NHS logo on it. It's kind of like commemorating all the hard work you've done.
He's talking about a National Honor Society stole, the white satin with a seal you've probably seen at countless graduations. It's worn by NHS members who maintain a high GPA and commit to community service. But at Plano Senior High, it's not allowed.
I was really looking forward to wearing it and just being able to say, like, I was a part of it, because I have friends that go to East and West, and they're all wearing it. So it's like, I don't know why we're not allowed to wear it. I don't get it.
His mom's frustrated, too.
They deserve it. They worked so hard for it.
She wrote to the principal and says she got this message back. Graduates do not wear any club or organizational regalia. The National Honor Society sponsor told her the administration wants everyone to feel included in graduation and not single students out.
If you choose not to work that hard, then that's okay. I mean, I wasn't an NHS kid. I didn't wear the NHS stole when I graduated, but friends of mine did, and I was okay.
Garrett thinks it's too late for him.
We've talked about trying to get a petition, talking to the principal.
But he hopes the policy can change so other Plano students can share in a national tradition.
The whole country recognizes NHS. I don't know why just Plano can't recognize it.
And I do. I know why. Because it's not that you are being, see, how can I word this? These students that didn't get it are demanding to be treated equal to you. And I think this is bullshit. Absolute freaking bullshit. And this is exactly what I told you guys was going to happen. With all of this, everybody gets a trophy. Everybody gets a trophy. Even if you were stupid and you sat on the damn bench all year, or you didn't show up to practice, you didn't work out at home, you didn't practice your grounding techniques or your kicking techniques, no matter what you were, or your basketball, you get a trophy too. Even if you didn't, you were just sitting there not even paying attention during half the games, you get a trophy too. You get the same trophy that the star player got. You're just as special as he is. Bullshit. That is bullshit, and you know it is, and that's exactly what's going on at Plano Senior High School. This is where my kids were set to go until I got them out of there because everybody was dropping dead of heroin overdoses. And, oh, I just wanted to come on here and just do my I'm right dance. Because I'm right. I was right. And you know it. I don't care who you are. You know I'm right. That it is the everybody gets a trophy mentality. And this way, it's reversed. Well, if we don't have a National Honor Society emblem, then they don't get to wear it either because we got a trophy too. That is bullshit. And you are screwing up kids. I don't care who you are or what you say. I'm right and you know it. Sorry, but I am. You know what I would do? Do you know what I would do? And you know what I would push the kids to do? I would push the kids to go get a temporary henna tattoo on their hands, on their wrists, on their arms, on the side of their neck that says NHS. I would do it in a freaking heartbeat. If you don't think I would, you don't know me. I would say, I will pay for it. Every one of you to go get a temporary henna tattoo that says NHS on the side of your face, on the side of your neck, and tell that PISD, the Plano Independent School District, to stick it straight up their ass. Because that's bullshit. These kids work hard. Harder than I worked. Harder than probably you worked. I wasn't in the NHS. Because I didn't work that hard. I probably could have been just like you could have been, but we didn't work that hard. These kids worked hard. They did it on purpose.
But we didn't get it, so they don't get one.
It's the same situation reversed. It's the same situation in reverse. Because it's people that are saying, well, if I don't get to be in the National Honor Society, then nobody gets to be in the... Bullshit! That just makes me so angry. Because these poor kids that deserve the recognition. And recognition is good. Recognition works. You know what I'm saying? Recognition is not a bad thing. It's like... It's right there for... It just makes me sick to my stomach. It really does. It's just ridiculous. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. And if you people do not stand up and try to say something about this around the world, around where you're at, it's just going to get worse and worse and worse. I'm sorry. I'm right. And you know I'm right. You just maybe don't want to admit it, but you know I'm right. All this stupid crap going on about, this, that, and the other, and just everybody gets a trophy now. No. The Jew has me blocked on Twitter. What a jerk. Who blocks a girl?
I'm just going to block her.
And I just have to say one thing. I have to bring this out into the open. I don't care who says something to me. I really don't. The fact that those people are even considering believing the insanity that slimy piece of shit is telling them. And then whenever he gets proven wrong, all he's going to say is, well, I told you I'm a troll and a liar. So this piece of shit thinks he gets a hall pass to do anything and say anything he wants. Because all he's going to do is come back and say, well, I told you I was a troll and a liar. Well, that is not a hall pass. That just means that you are probably the most untrustworthy person. It's no wonder you never have girlfriends or get married because you're a piece of shit. And I think it's great what you're doing to these people. These people deserve it. They're being led right down the path. Right down the path. And I'm just watching them go, da, 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 da. You know what I mean? Just sitting there watching them go, just going right down the pathway. And I think it's hysterical. Lots of notifications on Twitter tonight for some reason. Lots of notifications on Facebook, too. There's a lot going on. Yeah, this just really made me sick at my stomach. I was like, Jesus Christ, there you go. What did I tell you? What did I tell you? I'm going to see if I can find anything else on it. Plano Senior High School. And the National Honor Society. Let's see what we have here. Here's one that was just a few hours ago. Plano Senior High School students told they cannot wear their in it. That just steams me. Unbelievable. Unfreaking believable. I wish that somebody out there was listening to me and just do what I said. Do what I said. Go and get a temporary henna tattoo somewhere. I don't know where. Just go and do it somewhere. Oh, here we go. We have some stuff already up on YouTube. Let's see what we have here. If it opens. We'll just have to wait a second and see.
This is Michael B. of Seeking Higher Truth and the newly created Mike's Hot Seat, Left Is Never Right on Blog Talk Radio, Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. Central Time. Plano, Texas. National Honor Society winners will not be able to wear their awards on their graduation. The school's reasoning is that by allowing the awards to be worn, other students would feel excluded. So in the mind of the neo-Marxist liberal, we have to exclude success so other people won't feel excluded. Garrett Frederick, who's set to graduate in Plano, is a National Honor Society winner. He did 20 hours of community service every semester to win that award. And yet, the school is not letting him celebrate it. So I say this to the parents. Take your kids away out of that graduation ceremony. Have your own ceremony. I think a parent should has a big backyard, have their own graduation. A couple of parents can stand up, hand out the diplomas as if they were in school. Contact local media. Contact Drudge, Matt Drudge at drudgereport.com. Contact Alex Jones at Infowars.com. Let your voice be heard. Don't stand for this nonsense. And you don't need a lawsuit. You don't need a riot. You just have your own ceremony. We need to stop this nonsense. This is all to discourage success. They want our children to accept mediocrity as the norm. Some of your children may not understand it, pulling them out of the school's graduation ceremony and having your own. But one day they will, and they will thank you for standing up against this nonsense and for having your kids' backs. Say no to this graduation. And Christians, on a side note.
No, 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 no. You're wanting to take the sissy way out. Well, let's just don't go. No, no, no. Wrong, buddy. What they need to do is when they go up there and receive their diploma, go, yay, National Honor Society member. I mean, come on, people. When you're going to fight back, you got to fight back. But I was raised by somebody that taught me how to do it, okay? Unbelievable. I'm in shock. I'm in shock. I mean, I'm not in shock. I mean, I told you. That is going to happen. And I guarantee you, it's the same freaking, like he said, Marxist bullshit where they're making everybody feel just on the same level. Bullshit. You're not on my level and I'm not on your level. Nobody is. People are more intelligent. People are less intelligent. People are funnier. People are more trepid. People are different. Nobody's on the same level. It's just ridiculous. Jesus Christ. Here goes another one. This looks like it's on some television show. Let's see what we have here.
Well, the graduation announcement is getting a lot of backlash because honor students were told they cannot wear their stoles. Graduates at Plano Senior High School in Texas say they were told not to wear their National Honor Society regalia when they graduate later this month. Now, these are students, by the way, who've maintained the grades and they've been committed to community service. The school says it's the school's policy for graduates to not wear any club or organizational regalia. Plano ISD did issue a statement saying the school opted not to include additional regalia for graduation. Now, this morning, I have one mother here and a son who are directly affected by this because they're saying it's not fair that these kids who've worked so hard can't wear their sashes. Kellyanne Frederick is here with her son, Garrett. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So, Mom, when did you hear about this policy?
A little over a month ago, Garrett came home from school and said, Mom, kids are saying at school that on graduation we're not going to be able to wear our NHS stoles. And I'm like, well, that can't be right. They did it when I graduated from school, you know, forever ago. So I sent the principal an email asking her what the deal was. In my email, I mentioned that I heard a rumor because I couldn't believe that it could really be true. But, you know, lo and behold, the next day she wrote me back and said, indeed, it wasn't a rumor that they weren't wearing them.
Yeah, and Garrett, you've been a part of this since, what, sophomore year?
Yes, ma'am.
So you've been looking for it. Because I remember when I was in high school, there's a ceremony. We joined the National Honor Society.
It's a big deal.
It's a big deal.
Yes, ma'am.
There are candles and there's a walk and all kinds of stuff.
Yes.
So you were looking forward to this.
Yes, ma'am.
So when you found out that you couldn't wear your stole, I mean, what was going through your mind?
First, I was kind of upset, disappointed almost, just because I've worked so hard. And not just me, but all my other NHS peers have worked hard. So it's kind of like putting a damper on graduation for us. Kind of like, no, you're not that good. You're as good as everybody else. We're all equal kind of thing. So just kind of annoying.
Because you've had the grades and you, what about your community service? Talk about how much time you put
in. So sophomore year, I put in 20 hours. And then the past 2 years, I did 12 projects each year. And a project can consist of an hour tutoring in the morning or 3 hours at an elementary school for their game night or book fair. So it kind of like ranges. So I'd probably say in the past 3 years, over 60 hours have been put into this.
And what I understand, students at other schools in Plano can wear theirs, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have.
It's just Plano Senior High School that has this rule.
Right. Plano has three senior highs, Plano, Plano East, and Plano West. And Plano East and Plano West both allow their students to wear their NHS stoles for the kids who are NHS. Mm.
Now, is it just the NHS stoles? What about, like, athletes? Do they have special things they can wear during the ceremony?
No. Okay. Actually, at our graduation practice on Tuesday, our principal said that this was not about celebrating what organizations or clubs you were in. It's just about celebrating graduation, and that's it. So,
now, they will have, like, I understand, a basic sash they can wear that all honor students wear, but it won't have NHS on it.
Right. If you have a 3.6 GPA or higher, you get to wear a white sash, which is awesome because honors kids should be recognized, but an honors student is not necessarily an NHS student.
It's the extra component of volunteering.
So the school is not changing its rules. This is not going to happen. Graduation's next week.
Yes,
ma'am. So let's just go ahead. What are your plans after graduation? What are you doing? So let's celebrate that.
Yay.
After graduation, I'm going to be attending the University of South Carolina.
All right.
And I'll be majoring in sports management.
Good job. He's also a football player. Yeah. Well, Garrett and Kellyanne, thanks so much for joining us.
No, he's not a football player. He said sports management. Sorry. I'm still sickened, and I am sickened by this. I think it's unbelievable. What is this? School will not allow FTM student to have chosen name in yearbook. What is that? High school sports. Wait a minute. Let's see what... let me see. Breaks open any master. Right. Spore won't allow Indonesian ship to call. I want to see what else they have on this. This is making me puke. This is making me, I mean, I'm just like, whatever, you deserve it. You know, if I wish they would interview me, I'd say, because this comes from the idiocy of everybody gets a trophy. Everybody gets a trophy. Nobody's left out. No child left out. Well, I believe no, no, no. In fact, I'm going to play for y'all what I played that night when Sonny was on the show with me. And this tells you what it's like. Oop, hold on a second. Oops. Hold on. I'm doing the wrong thing. Hold on. Let me go back. Boink. I hit the wrong key on my keyboard. All right. Nope. Okay, hold on. Down key. Now enter. All right. Take a listen to this. All right? This is the way things should be. You know, some things just shouldn't change. Some things should not change. There's a lot to be said for tradition. A lot.
I can't believe we made it. According to today's regulators and bureaucrats, those of us who were kids in the 50s, 60s, 70s, or even early 80s probably should not have survived. Our baby cribs were covered with bright colored lead-based paint. We had no childproof lids or locks on medicine bottles, doors, or cabinets. And when we rode our bikes, we had no helmets. We drank water from the garden hose and not from a bottle. We ate cupcakes, bread, and butter, and drank soda with lots of sugar in it. But we were rarely overweight because we were always outside playing. We would leave home in the morning and play all day, as long as we were back when the streetlights came on. No one was able to reach us all day. Smartphones? We didn't have cell phones at all. No PlayStations, Xboxes, limitless channels on cable, laptops or tablets. Facebook was an actual face and an actual book. We had friends. We went outside and found them. We played dodgeball, and sometimes the ball would hurt. We fell out of trees, got cut, and broke bones and teeth. And there were no lawsuits from these accidents. No one was to blame but us. Remember accidents? We had fights and punched each other and got black and blue and learned to get over it. We made up games with sticks and tennis balls. And although we were told it would happen, we didn't put out any eyes. We rode bikes or walked to a friend's home, knocked on the door, rang the bell, or just walked right in and talked to him. Little League had tryouts, and not everyone made the team. Those who didn't had to learn to deal with disappointment. Some students weren't as smart as others, so they failed a grade and were held back to repeat the same grade. Tests were not adjusted for any reason. Our actions were our own. Consequences were expected. The idea of parents bailing us out if we got in trouble in school or broke a law was unheard of. They actually sided with the school or the law. Imagine that. Now, this generation has produced some of the best risk takers, problem solvers, and inventors ever. We had freedom, failure, success, and responsibility, and we learned how to deal with it. If you've related to anything that was just said, you're one of them. Congratulations. You made it.
Can you say why America is the greatest country in the world?
Diversity and opportunity.
Lewis?
Freedom and freedom. So let's keep it that way.
Well, why is America
not the greatest country in the world, Professor? That's my answer.
You're saying...
Yes.
Let's talk about...
Fine. Sharon, the NEA is a loser. Yeah, it accounts for a penny out of our paycheck, but he gets to hit you with it anytime he wants. It doesn't cost money. It costs votes. It costs airtime and column inches. You know why people don't like liberals? Because they lose. If liberals are so fucking smart, how come they lose so goddamn always?
Hey.
And with a straight face, you're going to tell students that America is so star-spangled awesome that we're the only ones in the world who have freedom? Canada has freedom. Japan has freedom. The UK, France, Italy, Germany, Spain, Australia, Belgium has freedom. So 207 sovereign states in the world, like 180 of them have freedom.
All right.
And yeah, you, sorority girl, just in case you accidentally wander into a voting booth one day, there's some things you should know. And one of them is there is absolutely no evidence to support the statement that we're the greatest country in the world. We're 7th in literacy, 27th in math, 22nd in science, 49th in life expectancy, 178th in infant mortality, 3rd in median household income, number 4 foreign labor force and number four in exports. We lead the world in only three categories: number of incarcerated citizens per capita, number of adults who believe angels are real, and defense spending, where we spend more than the next 26 countries combined, 25 of whom are allies. Now, none of this is the fault of a 20-year-old college student, but you nonetheless are, without a doubt, a member of the worst period generation period ever, period. So when you ask what makes us the greatest country in the world, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Yosemite? Sure used to be. We stood up for what was right. We fought for moral reasons. We passed laws, struck down laws for moral reasons. We waged wars on poverty, not poor people. We sacrificed. We cared about our neighbors. We put our money where our mouths were, and we never beat our chest. We built great big things, made ungodly technological advances, explored the universe, cured diseases, and we cultivated the world's greatest artists and the world's greatest economy. We reached for the stars, acted like men. We aspired to intelligence. We didn't belittle it. It didn't make us feel inferior. We didn't identify ourselves by who we voted for in the last election, and we didn't scare so easy. We were able to be all these things and do all these things because we were informed by great men, men who were revered. First step in solving any problem is recognizing there is one. America is not the greatest country in the world anymore. Enough?
I agree with every word he just said. We are not anywhere near the greatest country in the world. We used to be. Not anymore. We're raising a bunch of emasculated, at their own hands, self-emasculated men. Because everybody wants to be so PC, so politically correct. We have to be careful what we say. Not, we'll make them mad. Well, I say, fuck that. I'm not. Nope, not me. Not me. I'm not going to do that. You're right, David. Thank you for saying that. My daughter just says, hi, Mom. Thank you for being so understanding. It seriously means a lot. I love you so much. How many of your daughters said that to you, huh? And you know who I'm talking about. Not my immediate listeners out there. I've got these idiots. I've got this one lame idiot on this network, people that are out there listening. There's this one idiot chick who is an admitted. What's that word that they say? Bipolar. She has admitted to it. She has bipolar. She has all this crazy stuff. And has the nerve to say last night, I'm sorry, but I don't mess with those mentally ills. I'm like, oh my God, you sadistic bitches. You're so bad. You're what's wrong with this country. Half of you are. Even on this network, I see idiocy everywhere I freaking go. And the lies. We learned the other night. What did we learn? This is what got them all flubberblusted. There's a word for you, Jew. Flubberblustered. She makes up words all the time. And any clip I've made is just 2 weeks old. Well, there you go. I love to sit back and watch the people believe that idiot. And then, when he gets called out for being a liar, he just says, I told you I'm a troll and a liar. So I'm going to remind you people. He's a liar. Don't believe a freaking word he says. He's lying about everything he says. She just responds to me. Now I respond to the people that talk to me about the bullshit that you say. I think it's funny. Keep going, because you'll never be back on this show again. You wormed your way back in. Consider yourself lucky. I, for the first time in my life, can honestly say I hate you. I hate everything about you. You are putrid. Are you mad? No. This is called talking. Okay? This is talking. This isn't mad. Jesus Christ. Are you mad? Do I sound mad? No. This is called a voice. But all I have to say, wait just a second. Excuse me. I hate to do that. All I am saying is I think it's great that you are just on these new people like a leech. You're just like, you just zoomed in on them like a bunch of zooming in things, whatever that is. Like, I don't even know what I'm talking about here. Like, no, I'm mad, David, because he's going to say she's responding. No, even your stupid best friend said, Jew, I'm sorry, but you respond to her. Do you know that Victor said, I should get Victor in here because he was talking about this earlier. Do you know how much time it takes you to go through one of my shows and clip it like you do? Do you know how much time that takes? Bitch, I'm all you think about. You're obsessed. You need to own it. You're freaking obsessed. I talked to a friend of mine on Skype today, and I explained it to him. For some reason, when I was explaining it to him, it made a hell of a lot of sense. And I'll tell you exactly what I said to him. I won't tell you what he said to me. But I said to him, he didn't really understand what was going on. And I said, it's very simple. It's very simple. I said, hold on just a second. I'm scrolling up because we talked for a long time. Hold on, I'm scrolling up. Up. Oh my God, it's a long thing. It was a long talk. Okay, I will say what he said. He goes, don't you dare let that bastard back on your show. And I said, Psalm 91, brother. It's right here with me on the wall, and it's in my wallet. It says, you will trample on the serpent. And I said, also, never mistake kindness for weakness. And I said, to be hated is actually something very special. It means that you're pissing people off, and that's what we want. Now, don't get me wrong, I said, people can be hated like Satan is for doing evil things, but when you don't do anything offensive, that's the good hate. When people hate for no reason, it's envy, one of the deadly sins. I said, Jesus of Nazareth was hated, and we are all taught to be Christ-like. Hell, they killed him. They spat on him. They mocked him. No wonder he went into the garden that night and said, get me out of this deal. Take this cup away from me. God turned his back on him, though. And then he did say, you are something else, Debbie. I said, but what am I? And he said, we were talking about something else. I said, I love doing the ninja attack when they don't think I'm reading the chat room. And then I ban them. I said, I banned him in mid-sentence. He says, he is a blankety, 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 blank. And I said, he's a very cruel person. I hate liars. And that's okay, because Jesus hated. You could hear it in his words sometimes. Okay, hold on just a second. I said, he goes, wow, did you see your listener account on Lightning Radio today? And I said, are you kidding me? And I sent an email to these people today, and I said, that's the last you'll hear from me. I said, and then I got knocked offline on my show. I said, he is really pushing me. Push, push, push. So anyway, I don't know what this is he sent me. What is that one? It says...
time to unleash the beast.
Exactly, David. You're exactly right. It's horse shit. It's bullshit. And I figured out last night in one breath who Dago DeFago is. I know people are going to be saying, why did you ban Stabby McHugs? Why do you think I banned Stabby McHugs? Because Stabby is too erratic. One day he loves me, one day he hates me. One day he loves me, one day he hates me. Stabby can't make up his mind. And he said in my show last night that he was not at. He comes in there later, and I made sure I kept it. He says, all hail Heather's unplanned, unwed children from two fathers. God bless secular America. Stephen is a foul-mouthed asshole, typical Call of Duty player who curses at random players over the mic besides a 15-year-old. Saying this is any kind of a show is a stretch. It was more like a Skype call. You know something? I better make sure that that was Stabby. Because, you know, the idiot has 15,000 sock accounts. Blocked users. Let me see who we have. Oh, I don't think he's blocked. Wait, okay, I unblocked him. Now, let's go back and see if it's the real Stabby. Because you never know. But I just got fed up with it. I was just like, I'm just exhausted with it. And it happens when I'm under the, when they, wow, 700, Jesus Christ. Let me see if this is him. Hold on, I'm checking. Bump, 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 bump. Tink. Yep, it's Stabby. What is wrong with you, McHugs? What is wrong with you? I'll unban you just because you're a friend of the show's, but Jesus Christ, lay off my kids already. Are you kidding me? Why would you say something like that? My daughter is engaged to be married and is going to be getting married very soon, but I just don't talk about it because it's nobody's fucking business. And what was it? What got you all flubber-blusted at Heather? What did she do to you? Your hate is in an ebb tide. It comes and goes. I really think you deserve to go back over to the other side because you people have drawn lines in the sand. You know you have. I haven't done it. Y'all did it. Y'all draw lines in the sand. It's either you must hate or because... And the people that know, people that are on the other side are easy to name. I've told you 1,000 freaking times. Todd Morris, Desert Rose, Angela, the One Angry Jew, and Goofy Bone. Duh. I've been telling y'all that since October 25th of 2013 when I was on Jay Sand's show that night. I said, here they come. They found me. None of them had podcast over here yet. I was already podcasting. Hell, I'd already been on Jay Sand's show for a month. Here they came. And what they do is very common to what groups like of people like that do. First, they start the lies. Well, first they start the hate. Then they get other people to join. All right, join in with them. And they usually fail. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to leave it up to you people. If you people are going to buy into their shit, you deserve to be whatever happens to you. I mean, I'm just saying, you deserve whatever you get into. That's all I'll say. I mean, I'm not a bad person. Everybody that listens to the show knows I'm not. They're just lying your ass. They're lying their asses off. And Felicia, get out of my goddamn room, you two-faced bitch. Okay? Get out of my room. I'm not going to throw you out, but please get out of my room. Don't stink it up. You're a lying, two-faced bitch is all you are. Well, she just doesn't like any women. No shit, I don't like women. I can't stand women. Women are the most two-faced, catty, lying, jealous, envious pieces of shit. I mean, don't get me wrong. I have some great friends. But mostly, they're just bitches. You should have heard that stupid bitch last night on the Jew show. She was going, oh, I know. I know. Let me tell you something, Felicia. You're trying to stick your nose into something you know nothing about, all right? You don't know anything about this shit. Okay, this crap goes way the fuck back, okay, way back with this group of people. This little group of people followed me over here from another network. They are sick fucks, and they are trolling the shit out of you. In fact, I'm going to read aloud on the air what I wrote to her. It has to be done. Oh, yeah, we just slipped into talking about drama. She's a drama wizard. No, you people are the drama kings and queens, not me. I respond to your fucking bullshit. I was having nothing but fun on this goddamn show. I said, "Dear Liz, I'm not sure you realize who and what you're dealing with when you're dealing with the one angry Jew. This is a very sick, vile man who is trolling the shit out of you. He's laughing behind your back. My best advice for you and your friends at this point is to back out of this sick little game that these people are playing with you. And if you choose not to believe me, well, all